State Warriors going up against the Utah Jazz. And for Utah, they dropped the first matchup against this squad. They'll try to even the series in tonight's game. And what a joy to behold opening night of a new NBA season. A fresh start for everybody, including us.
My side, Chris Webber and Greg Anthony from the sideline. Hall of Famer David Aldridge. It's all about the Western Conference. That's where the action is today as the Golden State Warriors get ready to battle. Last time they met was in Utah where they beat the Jazz.
And Kevin, you know, they showed how important it is to have a strong bench. I mean, when you are on the road, that depth is vital. I think they really utilized the second unit to extend their offensive assault and just really wore down their opponent.
Oh, man, the reserves were great. Give them credit. They provided intensity, energy. They gave the offense a tremendous boost.
And checking out Utah's opening lineup, a tall wing pair with Hood at the two and Hayward at the small forward. Horace Diaw is out there with Gobert, and it's Exum in at the point. Diaw the pass to Hayward, and Hayward with the stuff.
And a sturdy screen set for him that time, and he doesn't fool around, just straight to the rim for the finish.
No way for his man to get around that one, that's for sure.
You're right, they are precise in how they ran that play. Exceptional timing, that's all good stuff.
So the Utah Jazz able to put the first points up on the board. Five to shoot, Thompson dishes to Green. From 10 feet out, the shot off that time, so Utah will take it the other way. Well, one thing about Draymond Green, he isn't very bashful when it comes to sharing what's on his mind.
Well, Draymond knows what he's about and can back up everything he says. The team doesn't mind when he'll call someone out in the media or take a verbal jab, because when he messes up, he's the first to call himself out to a reporter. Green essentially is that guy who is saying to the media what every other NBA player really wants to say.
Another miss by Curry.
He's clanking everything to start this game.
And keeping us updated from the sideline, let's swing it over to David Aldridge.
Well, I did get a chance to speak with Steve Kerr a little bit. He told me they always have to be alert, and especially against this team because of its discipline and focus. He said we'll get embarrassed if we're inattentive at the defensive end. We must stick with our principles and do the little things. Kevin, they did win the first meeting of the season, and we'll see if they can get it done again tonight.
Okay, Dave, thanks. Well, guys, it really makes sense to have their defense poised to deal with the great shooters on the floor tonight.
It really does. If they can't keep the damage done by those guys to a minimum, then it's going to be a long night.
And if something isn't initially working on defense, don't just stay in that rut. Be willing to think outside the box to find a solution.
A shot by Thompson, and no one's around. And he misses the go-ahead basket.
And they're 1 of 5 to start this game. Just really haven't gotten into a flow offensively.
First quarter of basketball, just over 2.5 minutes play. Shots good by Green.
Oh, that shot looks so good now. I love the backspin, the follow-through. You can tell Draymond's been working on it.
Diaw, the screen. Now Exum, outside Hood, fires the three. Green with the rebound. Curry with the three, rebounded by the Jazz, feeds it to Exum, and Diaw kicks to Hood, back to Diaw. Diaw with a screen on Durant. Here's Exum, still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for him. And as we have a moment now, let's take a look at the three-pointer to two-pointer shot ratio here in the postseason for the Warriors. And we're approaching about 3.5 minutes played in the first quarter. Green, the screen. Curry kicks to Thompson. And off the front iron, and in it goes.
Recognizing the defensive imbalance, Curry quickly locates the open man.
Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Diaw, the screen. Hayward kicks to Hood. Diaw, the pass to Hood. And it's Hood again missing.
That's exactly how you have to defend him. He's a guy that the D needs to be aware of at all times.
Thompson with the bucket.
Oh, great ball movement there.
For the Utah Jazz, they won their last contest, that game against Memphis. Diaw, the screen. Exum kicks to Hayward. To the paint. Trying to find Diaw. Gets it to him. Will it go? Through the D for the layup. And here is Curry. He hasn't scored yet. That I'm sure will change. Pass to Durant. Outside Green. And airballs the triple. That one was way off. Kicks to Exum. Diaw sets the pick for Exum. Shot clock at 6. With the shot. And the shot clock expires. 24-second violation. With this chance, let's show you the league's most intimidating shot clock and defenses from last season. Second, the Warriors.
Last season, these guys blocked a lot of shots. Athletic, aggressive, protecting the rim was one of their highest priorities.
Outside Curry. The 11-footer. It's stolen by Gobert. Now, here's Exum. Tight defense on him. Gobert, the screen. Here's Hayward. Offensive rebound. Exum with it. Dia with it, and Curry picks him up defensively. A shot by Hayward, wide open, hits the front of the rim and out.
He looks super awkward attempting that look, and it's because he didn't get set first before shooting.
Dishes to Exum. Dia, the screen. Now, here's Exum. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Back to Hayward. Jacks up a three. And that comes off the assist
timeout,
by Exum.
Timeout.
Well, two words that feel awfully nice to say after a long summer. Chris, opening night.
You're right, Kevin. I love it, baby. Time to show and prove. No more waiting. Let's kick this off right.
Yes. Good one.
You know, I think he just wants to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and I think that's a wise timeout.
Yeah, and he may have seen something out there that he'd like to try to exploit. We'll see what they come out with.
JaVale McGee's checked in for Pachulia. And a switcher also for Utah. Max checked in. The Warriors leading. Durant kicks to Green. Thompson against Hood. Thompson dishes to Curry. And fouled hard that time. He'll get to the line and shoot two. Well, we hear so much about Curry and his offense, and rightly so. But you know what, Chris? He's an above-average defender in his own right.
He is not going to be considered one of the best all-time defenders at his position. But he is a very solid defender and has improved in that area every year he's been in the league.
The Warriors shooting their first foul shots of the night here.
And going back a season ago, they were a pretty average team at the line, about 76% altogether.
And the two-time league MVP, Steph Curry, one of only two active guys to win the MVP more than once in well over a decade.
And the Warriors making a change here. Iguodala's checked in. And Utah also making a switch. Johnson, he's checked in for Boris Diaw. And both free throws good for Curry. We take for granted the magician-like moves Curry can pull off with the ball. But, Chris, it's something that he's worked on very hard his entire career.
Curry has made leaps and bounds in his improvement with his ball handling. Arguably, with Uncle Drew, he is the best ball handler in this league at this point. He did a lot of drills dribbling tennis balls to up his feel and handle on the court.
And here is Curry after Gordon Hayward hitting the three. Here's McGee. And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here. This is his first trip to the line tonight. The first free throw is good.
The Warriors do so many things well, but what they are most known for is their ability to shoot it from deep. Led by the Splash Brothers, but everyone on this roster can shoot a three. They can turn a two-point lead into a 15-point lead in under a minute when they start letting it fly from outside.
Catching up on the changes for Golden State. David West, he's checked in for Green, for Thompson. And it's Livingston in for Curry. And the stats for the Warriors, three-point shooting over the last few seasons, is just astounding.
Well, just look at the stats. As a team in 2016, they shot 41.6% from beyond the arc, by far the highest mark by a team for the season. Actually, it's the second highest percentage all time in the NBA, trailing the 1997 Charlotte Hornets. Oddly enough, that Hornets team also featured a three-point sniper, a Curry, Dale. Steph's father was one of the better ones.
McGee. And, there's a whistle. He was going up for a layup, and while it looked like there was some contact, I wasn't sure they were going to call it a foul shot or not, but sure enough they have. So he'll head to the free throw line. The Warriors have been successful on three of their four free throw attempts up to this point. That's good from McGee. Utah's gone 3 of 4 on three-pointers in the first quarter, doing well from long range. Mack, the pass to Favors. Jazz passing it around. Pass to Ingles. Back to Favors. Here's Mack. The three-pointer, no good. Golden State's gotten just 2 of 6 to fall from three-point range so far in the first. On the wing, Iguodala. Now the pass to McCaw. Misses the three.
Not quite enough defense. That time around, just lucky he was off.
From deep, Johnson. Rebound by JaVale McGee.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
Baseline jumper. Iguodala, no good. Utah trailing here. And Mack has it in the corner. Wide open look. That one falls, coming off Johnson's feet.
Timely passing leads to assists, and that's been the recipe for success.
Warriors shooting 36% in this first quarter, trying to get their bearings. And down it goes. Dunk threw off a wonderful assist.
Still with enough explosiveness and with great length to finish, Sean Livingston.
And Favors kicks to Mack. Here's Ingles. He's covered by Iguodala. The shot's good. Guys, no one team gaining control early on.
Yeah, and you look at the lead changes. 6 already.
McCaw, the pass to Livingston. Here's McCaw. To the middle. McGee's shot is off.
That's what we call good defense in the paint. Worth its weight in gold.
Well, that's just a stupendous effort by him right there. He stopped him dead in his tracks.
Now here's Favors, and it's JaVale McGee with the foul. That is his first foul of the game. Hood kicks to Favors, and the rebound goes to the Warriors. McGee's got his third rebound tonight. Now here's Livingston. He's covered by Mack. Now Livingston, and Derek Favors picks up the foul. That's his first foul. Here's McCall. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one.
The defense took a big risk leaving him wide open and got lucky. He clanked that outside shot.
Mack dishes to Favors. And it's JaVale McGee with the foul. That's foul number 2 for him.
And that's his second foul already. And that's going to force him to tone down his aggression defensively.
Clark, he's checked in for Golden State. Lyles checked in for Utah. Utah with the ball. Here's Mack. Passes to Lyles. The dish to Ingles. 4 on the clock. From 11 feet away. Lyles no good.
That was just textbook defense. As soon as he caught the ball, the D surrounded him.
Well, we knew that he was funny from working with him, but Steve Kerr has demonstrated many times, Chris, just how smooth he can be with the media.
And you can't downplay how much that means to a team. With the Warriors, Kerr provides them a buffer for criticism with his wit.
So it's Utah now after the missed 3 from Iguodala. Kicks it out to Johnson. 3-pointers off the mark. The Warriors trailing. Livingston passes to Clark. Back to Livingston. The feed now to McGee. McGee sets the pick for Iguodala. Back to McGee. It's stolen by Johnson. Now 8 seconds separating the 2 clocks. Favors and a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for 2. It's his first trip to the line.
And just a shade over 70% from the line a season ago. That's an area I'm sure he wants to improve.
And that one falls for Favors. Both good from the line that time. Warriors trail by three. Iguodala kicks it to West. He feeds it to Clark. Picked by West. Great use of the pick to create room for the jumper. West has got his first basket of the night.
You can't afford to get him that kind of a look.
Horrendous defense right there. Does the defense know who they're leaving wide open? You can't do that with him.
So at the end of one quarter of play, still a close game. Utah out in front. They're up by one. The second quarter coming up right after this break, so don't go anywhere. Certainly one of the game's bigger personalities, Draymond Green.
Most importantly, it's just about how the guys respond to me. And, you know, just really bringing that energy and that attitude and that fire each and every night, every day, whether it's in practice, whether it's, you know, in the game, whatever it is, just always bringing that energy and that passion.
A heart and soul guy, Draymond Green, has the kind of spirit guys that everyone else can just kind of feed off of.
Yeah, his talents and contributions now being appreciated. He's forced his way into the discussion of top 10 players in our league.
And so far, it's been a closely contested game as we get the second quarter up and going. And the guys, what's your take on Utah so far?
I tell you what, the scoring has come in threes for the most part here so far.
Yeah, and at some point, you'd think the defense would extend out and try to run these guys off their spots or at least make them shoot a little earlier than they'd like.
All fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset the lineups courtesy of Gatorade as the second quarter gets going. And Golden State looking at who they've got. Green is out there with Durant. Then there's Ian Clark. And there's Klay Thompson. And it's Curry in at the one. Another miss by Curry.
And that's playing into the hands of the defense right there.
When it really went well, according to plan there for the D, they completely baited them into taking that shot, making that move, and they were ready for it.
And that's the kind of lead pass we've come to expect from him.
He dishes it to Clark. Back to Curry. Stolen by Exum. Just over 1 minute has passed here in the second quarter. Here's Mack. No good on the triple. Golden State's gone 1-2 on three-pointers here in the second quarter so far. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, guys, some might say that Draymond Green has a big mouth. Klay Thompson said he talks to us, himself, coach, the other bench. But Andre Iguodala had the cap, fellas. He said if you're having a conversation about potato chips, then he's going to make sure his opinion is heard.
They love that edge he brings, D.A. Absolutely. Thanks. Clock at two. And they turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock violation. This is the list of last season's top shooters from the charity stripe. These guys were practically automatic. Number one, Steph Curry. Kevin Durant, third.
And how about the work both of them put in from the foul line? Just such a consistent, dependable performance from both.
From past the arc, Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got his fifth rebound in this one. And the Stifle Tower, the French rejection, whichever name you want to give for Rudy Gobert, it probably speaks to his tremendous rim protection abilities, Graham.
Man, a few years back at the Combine, his wingspan measured at a record 7 feet, 8.5 inches. Clearly one of the league's premier shot blockers. Very difficult to shoot a high percentage against him. And at the offensive end, he's become an excellent rebounder and finisher in traffic.
And Durant sends it back.
But you're not going to sneak that shot past Durant, not with the reach that he has.
And the Warriors making a change here. Pachulia's checked in. And Utah with a change here, too. Diaw's checked in. On defense, the Warriors. And Mack kicks to Hayward. Good, and the nice assist from Mack. And that's 11 points for Gordon Hayward.
So versatile, always pushing the action offensively.
three, dishes to Green. And for those of you just joining us, in the second quarter with about 3 minutes gone by.
Now, always keeping his head up, Draymond rarely misses the open man.
And here's Exum, looking for his first basket still in this one. Down low, got a piece of it. But Julia with the steal. Here's Curry with the three, buries it from three-point range. Curry's got the game tied up here for the Warriors.
Oh, he's nailing a lot of his attempts right now. This might end up being a big game. I have no idea why he would have even attempted that. That's a horrible turnover.
And Utah making a change here. Hood's checked in. And a little under 3.5 minutes elapsed in the second quarter of play. Durant kicks to Curry. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on Rodney Hood. That is his first foul of the game. Here's Curry. He's got eight, and there's the foul. It'll go on Shelvin Mack. That'll be his second foul of the game. And here in the second quarter of action, as we approach 4 minutes played, Curry with a wide open look. Again, Curry missing.
And even without that three ball dropping for him, the defense should have done more on that last play.
Dio, the screen. Mack, the pass to Gobert. He kicks it to Hayward. Takes the three. Down through the hoop it goes. That's his fifth make on 9 shots from the floor.
Wow, what a special performance this guy's putting on from long range.
Yeah, absolutely. And the D seems content to let him keep firing from out there. And trust me, he will.
McCaw, he's checked in for the Warriors. Green, the screen. It's Curry outside. Good on the triple. Curry's got 9 points now in the quarter.
And he's now made 3 three-pointers here in the second, starting to get it going.
Gobert, the screen. Dio with it. 3-pointer, Hayward. Hayward missing again. Now here's Curry. Feeds it to Pachulia. McCaw, the pass to Green. And he misses the go-ahead basket. Utah's gone 2 of 4 from 3-point range so far in the second quarter. And Dio kicks to Hood. Pass to Mack. Gobert, the screen. Down to 5 on the shot clock. And Pachulia over to help. It's stolen by Curry. It's stolen by Mack. And now running it up the court. Mack pushing it up. And Dio gets it to go. The assist from Mack. And the Jazz lead by 2.
Wow, the floor just really opened up for him on that possession.
Well, of course it did. The D was nowhere to be found, and because of that, he easily spread down the court and got an easy bucket on him. They looked to him to bury those kinds of shots, even with the D all over him.
That three off the mark. Golden State's gone for the three-pointer 7 times here in the second and been successful 3 times. And again, no good by Golden State. Utah's gotten a lot of looks from outside tonight, 5 of 12. And looking at the Jazz roster, they're a well-balanced group. You see scorers, Greg, playmakers, rebounders, shot blockers, plenty of quality depth.
And they've done a great job of drafting. Many of the main pieces of the puzzle seem to be in place. The next step for me is, will one of these young core players emerge as a superstar?
Durant dunks
the ball.
Martin, such an effortless lift. He just goes up and throws it down like it's nothing.
Timeout is called, first of the game for the Jazz.
And they've gotten good looks, you know, so that's one reason they're frustrated. Maybe he can come up with something to get them an easy one, maybe get to the line.
Well, I just think they're pressing too much, not really in the rhythm. Have to let the game come to you.
Taking a look here at the numbers for Curry. Great showing for him last season. First in scoring, first in steals, and also he was the NBA's best free throw shooter, as close as it comes to automatic.
Utah comes into this one after the win against the Grizzlies in Memphis. And Mack kicks to Gobert. Gobert, the screen. For three, Diaw. No good on that one. Great T that time from Green. McCaw, the pass to Curry. Green, the screen. Here's McCaw. By Hood, Green. That one drops, and he's now 2 for 5.
And that's just another way Green can beat you. He has a reliable mid-range jump shot.
And Mack kicks to Diaw. Diaw, the screen. That's a 2 from Hood. The Jazz with another miss.
It's not winning basketball when you're attempting shots like that.
Oh, no, you're right. It's selfish on his part to attempt that. Should have passed it back out and tried to get a better look.
Here's McCall. By Hood. And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it.
He just lost where he was on the court. It ended up out of bounds there.
And some changes here for the Warriors. Andre Iguodala is checked in for Green. And it's Livingston in for Steph Curry. Derek Favors checked in for the Jazz. Johnson comes in for Gordon Hayward. And Mack kicks to Diaw. Johnson outside. Back to Diaw. Stolen by Durant. Inside. And so he draws the foul on the shot. A trip to the line to shoot 2. And one thing we've seen from Kevin Durant so far in his career is that he shows up big when games mean the most. His team might not always win when the lights are the brightest, but he is still at his very best.
You are so right. Whenever he is on the national stage, it seems that is when he drops 40 and 10. And he's been playing in huge games his entire life and knows how to amp himself up. And while some stars can wilt or vanish in big games, Durant just seems to flourish.
West is checked in for Pachulia. And Utah also making a switch. Ingles is checked in. And he makes the first but misses the second. Well, the league, Chris, as you know, looking to cut down on the hack-a-shack, the hack-a-whoever intentional fouling down the stretch. Do you like those changes?
Well, I like the fact that the NBA came together and tried to find a remedy for something that they did not want to be a problem for our fans, and that's, you know, being bored to death, watch guys break free throws, they can't shoot free throws. I don't like the fact, though, that it does let guys off the hook that should be able to shoot free throws, and I don't like the fact that it hides a weakness, but I do like the fact that the NBA came together. I do think it'll address that problem, but the basic problem or the basic solution is kids, you know, free throws are the easiest part of the game to practice, literally, the easiest. Go out there and practice your free throws so you can go out there and get and ones and get a three-pointer the old traditional way.
Great points. And Mack kicks to Favors. And that misses. That would have put him up.
When he gets it that close to the basket, usually it's a sure flush. But the defense stepped up and stopped him cold in his tracks.
Iguodala dishes to Livingston. Golden State moving the ball around. Clock at 6. A shot. And they will call over the back on the play.
Yeah, not afraid of the physical play, but he still needs to stay under control.
Utah has gotten cold from deep in the second quarter, just 2 of 6 from long range. There's the pick. Favors passes to Hood. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. And Rodney Hood, talk about making a jump from year one to year two. Greg, he improved in almost every facet of the game.
And Hood came into the league with a reputation as a dead-eye shooter, and that's been the case from both long and mid-range off the bounce. What has surprised some people, though, is his advanced ball handling and his ability to find open teammates. A relatively quick study there. Still a ton of upside to Hood's game.
All free throws good from Hood. The Warriors trailing. Livingston passes to McCaw. West kicks to Livingston. Dishes it to McGee. Foul call that time on the way up. That'll give him two chances at the free throw line here.
And though the Jazz are, you know, still developing that roster, they do have an identity. And the one area that's been constant for them is defense. Number one in the league a couple seasons ago, last year near the top as well.
Take a break.
And so they're not going to be a
two
fun
shots.
Team for you to play against if you have one of those high-octane offenses.
That's good from McGee. And you know, an interesting thing about the Jazz defense, as proficient, Greg, as they've been, one wonders why the team hasn't done better in the win-loss column over the last few years.
And Kevin, the problem is, as solid as they've been defensively, that's how challenged at times they are offensively in terms of just scoring the basketball. They've been hanging around the bottom of the league in that category for a while.
There's a lot of former players now in coaching in the NBA. And let's say you had to assemble pickup squad from the head coaching ranks. Who are we talking about here?
Oh, man, that's a great question. I'm going Jason Kidd, Tyronn Lue, Steve Kerr.
Yes.
Earl Watson. How about Luke Walton?
Yes.
You know, and then Scott Brooks, Doc Rivers.
Yes.
Man, the list goes on and on.
That's right. And Utah making a change here. Isles checked in. West outside. Iguodala outside to the paint, got a piece of it, and stolen by Favors to the inside, and it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot, and we've got a moment now to look at the highest scoring teams in the NBA from last season. The Warriors, number one.
Yeah, number one in the league in terms of points per game a season ago. They play as a team, just really unselfish in terms of their brand of basketball.
First free throw is good, and everyone remembers the Warriors' regular season last year. But Chris, the highlight of all of it had to be the beginning. They rattled off a record 24 consecutive wins to start the season.
Well, Kevin, what is most amazing to me about how the start of their season went was how they were able to keep their focus. When you are on a win streak like that, everyone is gunning for you. You have the bullseye on your back. They're giving you the best game that they've got. That focus also helped the Warriors with their lengthy home streak. You have to be as tough as nails mentally to reach win streaks like that.
Exum's shot is off.
Oh, we've seen him posterize guys with that move many times. However, the defense proved to be very stifling.
Offensive rebound. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The Warriors have gone 7 of 9 from the free throw line tonight. And he knocks down the first one.
And it became clear early on in that 2015-16 season that the Warriors were going to be special. Everyone knew that they were going to be atop the standings all year, but you had to start viewing them in a historical context shortly into the season. Even with all the talk and the pressure, they still kept their composure to win 73 games.
That one misses. And Chris, with the Warriors and all this historical context talk, inevitably, they were compared to the team whose record they were chasing, the 96 Bulls.
Well, yeah, I don't get caught up in that argument. It's so hard to compare teams from today to teams that played two or three decades ago. I had to play against the 96 Bulls. But I tell you what, players were different. The rules were different. The style of game was different. It's really hard to say who would win.
Here's Livingston, and he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down. Well, guys, this first half has been about as tightly contested as you could hope for.
There have been a lot of lead changes. Goodness.
And we've got an update here, so let's catch up with David Aldridge.
Guys, the Utah Jazz is one of the up-and-coming teams in the West, and it was a system-wide commitment to young players. The younger teams tend to struggle, but head coach Quinn Snyder said he's committed to letting his players learn through their mistakes. He said it may be painful at times, but that's how we get better. In a lot of things, the only way to learn is through experience. Guys?
They're catching on quickly, thanks, D.A.
Yeah, they've gone away from the triple as they look to protect this lead.
There's 45 seconds left now here in the second. They could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Too many empty possessions. Right now, they need the basket.
Got it. Nice one there from Exum. Golden State's gone for the three-pointer 7 times here in the second and been successful 3 times. And McGee kicks to Iguodala. Pass to West. And there's the foul. It's on Trey Lyons. That's his first foul of the game, and the bonus will go to the free throw line. The Warriors have shot the ball pretty well from the line, going 8 of 11.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
That free throw, no good. So we can't get either to fall. One thing we've seen from these guys is excellent passing.
No doubt about it. It's fun to watch the way they're operating as a team right now. They are all in sync.
Now Exum kicks it to Favors. Just 3 on the clock, and it goes down 2 points. Favors has got 6.
And a big height advantage right there.
That's just a smart play. As soon as he caught the ball with the smaller man on him, he squared up and smoothly knocked that one down.
And we're through the first half of basketball here in what's been a good one. Jazz lead by 2. And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thank you, Kevin. With Coach Quinn Snyder. Quinn, what has to happen in the second half?
Well, we got to keep getting stops and really just make plays. Make plays on the offensive end and be solid defensively. No magic.
Pretty simple game, right, Coach? Thanks for your time. Back to you, Kevin.
Thank you, David, for that interview. And we'll see you back here after the break for third quarter basketball.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaq and Kenny. At an exciting time of the year as one of the first games of the... Gordon Hayward wasting no time getting hot. He had 14 points, 2 rebounds, and 1 assist. And, Kenny, what'd you see out there from the Jazz?
Well, their playmakers are showing up tonight, seeing the court well, moving the basketball. That's why they had so many assists in the first half. And they're not just relying on ISO plays to generate points.
Shaq, how'd you think the Warriors were playing?
Well, they're shooting in the low 30s from downtown. That's not disastrous. That's terrible. But it's a big reason why they're not winning this game. They need to run harder off the picks, try to get more open looks, and then the shooters got to finish the job. Yakum!
Welcome back to the Bay Area, everyone, as we take a peek at Coit Tower, at the skyline of gorgeous San Francisco just behind. The third quarter now beginning. Both sides looking to pull away in the last half of the game. Really an incredible game from Gordon Hayward.
Always been a dynamic scorer, and we saw in that first half the entire repertoire on display.
That's just an amazing skill set, plus the great instincts, knows intuitively how to get himself open.
The Warriors trail. Checking out the group for Quinn Snyder to start the second half. Exum and Hood are the one and the two. Rudy Gobert is out there with Boris Diaw, and it's Hayward in at the three. Chris, in the NBA now, there are a great deal of power forwards who take bits and pieces of your game and add it to their own. But when you grew up, who did you model your game after?
Oh, wow. Well, growing up, I mean, it's very simple. My favorite players are the players that I modeled my game after. As a big fella, I wanted to be a ball handler, and so the best ball handler was Isaiah Thomas. I wanted to be a great passer, so I looked at Magic and Larry Bird for those areas. I wanted to score, and so I looked at Larry Bird and Dominique in those areas. Hakeem Olajuwon, Charles Barkley. That's the great part about basketball. You know, we see greats today, but they wouldn't be as great as they are if it was not for the generation that came before them. Why? Yeah. Because you kind of know and you have a bar that you want to set, and it's, you know, hard to know how much to challenge yourself until you see that bar. So guys setting the bar, setting those expectations, setting those goals allows for guys to work on their game and get better. So, I mean, just think in 20 years, what will guys be doing out there with the generation that we have now out there setting the table for them?
Great perspective. The Jazz have made the most out of their opportunities at the line. They have yet to miss in 7 attempts. That's good from Exum.
And the Utah Jazz, with all their young talent, a team that's been on the cusp in the Western Conference, I mean, they felt they were ready to make a playoff push, and acquiring some quality veteran leaders with George Hill, Joe Johnson, and Boris Diaw, I think, is just what the doctor ordered.
Exum hits them both. And for the Jazz, Greg, do you like their moves this summer, adding all those veterans?
George Hill, I think, fits a need at the point guard, but can also play alongside Dante Exum. Boris Diaw, a skilled big man who fits well with Gobert and Derek Favors. And then Joe Johnson, a proven shooter and scorer in big-time possessions. So I think overall they did well.
Here's Diaw, and the layup's good off the glass. Diaw's got his third basket of the night right there. A great competitive game so far.
And from the look of it, this one could go right down to the wire.
Durant for three. Utah with the rebound. Diaw's got 3 rebounds so far in the game. Hood kicks to Gobert. And Pachulia pulls it down. Pachulia's got his 4th rebound with that last one here tonight. Thompson in the corner. Good, and it's Green picking up the assist. Thompson's got 12.
Not many guys more lethal on the catch and shoot. That's an easy bucket for Thompson.
Nice ball movement by Utah. Got it. Nice one there from Exum.
And that solid play in the paint continues here, guys.
And there's the pass to Pachulia. The screen from Thompson. Fader on the way. That one misses. And it's Utah the other way. They host the Kings after this game. That game marks the first half of a quick 2-game homestand. Green kicks to Curry. And Dante Exum picks up the foul. That'll be his 2nd foul of the game.
I mean, I like the call. I thought the defense was just there a little late.
And now around 2 minutes gone by in this half. Hayward against Durant. And stolen by Hayward. And here comes Hayward leading the fast break. Count it.
Yeah, that was the 3rd straight high percentage look the defense has allowed. The defenders have got to start putting bodies on bodies. And I tell you what, Gordon Hayward just steadily has grown into one of the better offensive players in the league. He does a great job of scoring it off the dribble. He's also at that small forward position can be kind of a point forward, if you will, with his playmaking ability. And I like to call him, use a baseball term, he's like a five-tooler. I mean, he does all the things you want a basketball player to do well on the floor. And to cap it all off, he is a great teammate as well.
There's Green with the three. Rebounded by Hood.
Just enough coverage to bother that three-point attempt.
Well, we're into the third quarter, just over 2.5 minutes played. Diaw sets the pick for Hood. Exum. Off target from outside. Talking about Hayward's versatility on offense, some would say his ability to cover smaller, quicker players defensively is another reason his star is on the rise.
His ability to get stops on the ball, as well as provide quick help to his teammates, is really priceless. The question now is ceiling. How much better overall can Hayward get? Some think he's more of a number two guy than a superstar. Some will tell you the sky's the limit.
Gobert, the screen. Three-pointer, Hayward. The Jazz with another miss. Warriors have gone 3-6 in the third quarter, 50% from the field. Such a wide open look. And that's now 6 points for Kevin Durant.
Yeah, that's too good a look to give him from behind the arc.
And Diaw kicks to Hood. Diaw with a screen on Thompson. Diaw against Durant. Shot clock at 5. Here's Exum. Rebounded by Curry.
He's really had a rough quarter on the offensive side of the floor.
To the inside, and the ball travels out of bounds. It was last touched by Diaw. And a look here at the shot chart.
Well, they're going to have to look elsewhere for points because he has pulled a Houdini and completely disappeared from the offense in this one. Just no production from him, and nothing seems to be in rhythm for him right now. It's just not his night.
So it's the Warriors now. The lead is 2.
He's tried to get it going, but the shots simply have not been there. Nothing seems to be falling.
Exum kicks to Hayward. This one for 3. Hayward missing again. Golden State's gone 3-5 with the long ball since entering the second half. Thompson in the corner. From past the arc. That one, no good. 18 that time from Hood. In the corner, it's Hayward. Back to Exum. To the middle. And he was fouled in the act of shooting. Chance here now for a three-point play.
Important points there. Got him on a nice play, getting the ball inside and right to the bucket.
And the Warriors making a change here. McCaw's checked in. Max checked in for Utah. For Utah, they have made a mistake at the line yet. 10 of 10. Chris, you look at this Warriors roster. There are a lot of unique players at every position.
Oh, yeah, I get what you were saying, and it makes total sense when you look at their personnel. Guys like Draymond, you never see as a functioning point power forward. Curry is unique in how he plays the point and his shooting. The list goes on with guys like Iguodala, too.
Diaw, the screen. Hood for 3. Another miss by Utah.
No reason to chuck that one up there. The D was right in his face, all over him. Not a good decision.
And the jam by Kevin Durant. A great competitive game so far.
And from the look of it, this one could go right down to the wire.
Hood kicks to Mack. Diaw, the screen. There's the triple. Mack, good. Mack's got 5 points so far.
Both teams trading punches back and forth. This thing's like a heavyweight fight.
I think a good indication of that, this will be an absolute battle for the entirety of this game.
And Thompson kicks to Kerr. That's in, coming off the assist from Thompson. Thompson's got 3 assists in the game. Last outing for Golden State, they won that game against the Trailblazers. Diaw sets the pick for Hayward. Here's Mack. And Utah, another 3.
Perfect screen there. Set him up with a terrific look.
Nice off-the-ball movement and action to free him up for a shot. He makes on a regular basis. Outstanding work.
Curry kicks to Durant. It's good. 10 points for him.
He's feeling it this half. Total turnaround after a rough first half.
Passes to Diop. Gobert dishes to Mack. Back to Gobert. And he uses the glass on the layup. And the Jazz lead by three.
No issues on that one. Good work all around.
Green with a screen for Curry. Durant with a screen on Hayward. The drive by Thompson. No good there off the double clutch. Jazz have gotten half their shots to drop in the second half up to this point, going 7-14. Here's Hood. Warriors with the rebound. Hood's off to Brooklyn after this game as they have the next to look forward to. That one will start off a three-game road trip for the team. Connects from three-point range.
Draymond sets his feet, catches, and releases in rhythm. Watch out.
And Mack kicks to Gobert. Gobert, the screen. Hood, the pass to Gobert. Unloads. And Hood with the basket on the assist by Gobert. Hood's got nine. Pardon?
Love the assist. I mean, he knew exactly where that bounce pass had to be to create that opportunity.
Gordon Hayward with another strong contribution so far in this one.
And he is absolutely dialed in from outside. They need to close out on him much quicker when he's lining up those threes.
And the Warriors with a completely new five on the floor. So Utah going with an almost entirely new group here. Derek Favors checked in for Rudy Gobert. Trey Lyles comes in for Boris Diaw. Johnson, he's checked in for Gordon Hayward. And it's Joe Ingles in for Hood. McGee is screen. Here's Iguodala. Six to shoot. West a screen on Favors. Iguodala with it. Favors picks him up. And again, no good by Golden State. Utah leading. And Mack kicks to Lyles. Looking for Mack. He gets it there. Johnson, a wide open look. No good on the three. Golden State's gone to the three-point shot eight times already in the second half and hit four of them. West kicks to Clark. McGee inside. Working on Favors. And now here is the 2K leaderboard with the list of the NBA's best teams from three-point land a year ago. The Warriors, number one.
You know, they went through stretches when they just didn't miss from beyond the arc. I mean, that carried them right to the top of that list.
The Warriors have had 15 tries at the line. They've made 10. And he can't get the first one.
And he's letting a lot of points get away at the free throw line tonight. It's got to be frustrating to have all that hard work not pay off.
Pachulia, he's checked in for David West. Second free throw, no good. Utah shooting 47% since getting things started in the third quarter. Mack dishes to Favors. And Derek Favors with the slam.
And how about that? What a sensational finish.
Yeah, you got to be able to get some hang time to do that one. Iguodala outside. Over to the left wing. Pachulia the pass to Iguodala.
Now, Andre Iguodala, he was my rookie back with Philly. I saw how hard he worked to fulfill his potential. There was a time when Andre Iguodala was the number one option on an offense. You have to give him credit for accepting a smaller role to be part of something special with this team. He has seen his numbers in scoring dip, but the wins have gone through the roof for him. He relishes the role of being the wingman who is there to compliment and help set up others.
The first one falls.
Oh, he turns it up. And though Iguodala has become a long-range shooting threat, he still managed to struggle from the line.
The Warriors making a switch here. Green's checked in. And Iguodala drops them both. Utah shooting not great, 40% for the game. And Mack kicks to Johnson. Jazz passing it around. Back to Favors. Down low. It's tipped. Iguodala with the steal. Let's it fly from 18. Ball's knocked loose. And that's out of bounds. Golden State will retain possession. And just about everything regarding Andre Iguodala is about team first.
Well, you can't forget how superb his defense still is, but you are dead on with his team first attitude. He walks the walk and is respected as a leader because of his unselfish nature. Not many players in the NBA can swallow their pride like he has done.
Clark kicks to Green. 6 on the shot clock. Golden State needs to get off a shot for the lead. Rebound by Johnson. Johnson's got his 4th rebound in this one. To the middle, and foul called as he misses. He'll go to the line and shoot 2. And it goes on Draymond Green.
Take a break. 2 shots.
Free throws good, Lyle.
Impeccable from the line since halftime.
Good on both.
We've seen it time and time again. Marksmanship from the line.
Livingston dishes to Clark. There's the feed to Green. He kicks to Livingston. Pass to Pachulia. Down low. And 2 free throws coming up as he misses that one. Drawing the whistle and a lot of contact there.
And you know what? You allow a guy to get right to the rim like that, that's your only option.
And that one falls for Clark. Hits one, then misses the second attempt from the free throw line. The dish to Matt. It's stolen by Livingston. Iguodala outside. 1:37 left in the third quarter. And here's Livingston. He feeds it to Clark. Shot clock at 5. And it's good, assisting on the play with Livingston. Clark's got the game tied up here for the Warriors. Utah shooting not great, 40% for the game. Feeds to Favors. He dishes it to Mack. Favors with the screen. Here's Ingles. He's covered by Iguodala. Unloads from 13. And that one's good by Favors. Favors got 10 points.
No, well, you just got to keep feeding him the ball. Everything he shoots has been gold so far.
Picked by Pachulia for the lead. And another 3 for Golden State.
And really, as the 3-pointers keep dropping, you get the sense that the frustration is mounting for the defense.
Now the Warriors moving it up. Here's Iguodala, and there are the Warriors now with another bucket.
Oh, such a terrific defender. Iguodala jump-starting that fast break.
And Matt kicks to Johnson. To the paint. Count it, and the Warrior lead has been cut to just 1 point on the basket from Ingles.
And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Now 8 seconds separating the two clocks. Green, the screen. Clark, the pass to Green. And airballs the triple. That one was way off. Mack with the ball. Here's Favors. Drilled it right as the clock hit all zeros.
Wow, what a clutch shot. He's got nerves of steel. Woo.
Nice. Able to keep his composure in the game's biggest moment. That's all about confidence, folks.
And a moment ago, inside the huddle with head coach Steve Kerr.
We're playing well, but it hasn't really paid off yet. If you guys stay with it defensively, it'll pay off.
Stay the course and better things will come. That's what Steve Kerr's message is to his team right there.
And as long as you're taking good shots, being aggressive on defense, you're doing all you can to win.
We've got a great game on our hands as we welcome you back. The fourth quarter of action getting started. Clay and Iguodala, the potent wing pair. Durant is out there with Green, and it's Curry in at the one spot. That's the Warriors' five. A three-pointer is right on target.
And this has really been a well-played game up to this point. And you know what? I bet it stays that way until the end.
Well, it's really been a tight contest. No reason to believe it won't be until the final buzzer.
Thompson from long range. Jazz leading by four. Now, here's Dion. Dishes it to Exum. And so he earns a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact, and he'll shoot two.
Wow, he got whacked on that one. Shouldn't be much debate there.
And the first one drops.
And it's been an outstanding game for them at the free throw line, not missing their chances when they get them.
He doesn't get the second one.
The focus. That trip to the line, they come away with a two-possession lead.
Thompson against Hayward. Durant kicks to Iguodala. Thompson for three. Rebounded by the Jazz. Hood's got his fourth rebound in this one. To the inside, Gobert. Beautiful dish, and the layup goes down. And the Jazz lead by seven.
And offensively, they seem to have turned a corner.
It's Curry with the drive. Iguodala kicks to Green. Fires the three. And the Warriors miss again. Utah shooting at 44%. Pretty reasonable. Final quarter here, and we're just over a minute and a half through it. Hayward can't hit.
He hasn't been the same in his second half shooting from the perimeter after an impressive first half.
Thompson dishes to Iguodala. Curry kicks to Iguodala. Thompson passes to Green. Lock at six. Here's Curry. Gobert with the defensive effort. Jazz leading by seven. Inside, the 11-footer. And it's off the back rim, no good. Golden State's gone 0-3 so far in the fourth quarter from long range. Curry kicks to Green. Some nice passing by Golden State. And again, it's the Warriors missing. Utah's gone 1-2 from three-point range here in the fourth. Pass to Exum. Gobert with a screen for Exum. Back to Diaw from the arc. That shot off. Nice D from Durant. Warriors have gone a dismal 0 for 5 to get the fourth quarter underway. And Andre Iguodala with the slam.
Oh, the quick jump of Iguodala. Easy one.
Diaw, the screen. Here's Exum. That short off the rim. Warriors trail by 5. Kicks to Durant. And then Durant with the dunk.
Oh, and he went for the two-hander on the slam using some muscle.
Some urgency from him there.
Sure.
Just tuning in, welcome. We've got about 3.5 minutes gone here in the fourth quarter. Hayward with the ball, guarded now by Durant. Durant against Hayward. From about 16, it's rebounded by Golden State. Durant's got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. Diaw with the steal. In transition, here come the Jazz. Goes up at the stripe and misses it off the right side of the rim.
And he has slipped into a funk. You can see the confidence is shaking.
Yeah, everybody goes through slumps. You can't let it get to him, though. Everyone makes mistakes on the floor. You just have to always be thinking about the next play.
Exum kicks to Diaw. There's the pass to Hayward. Put up top. Just 5 on the clock. Exum, a three-pointer off the mark.
He hasn't been able to sink anything, really. His team still leads, but it's unclear if he will find his game by the time this one ends.
Diaw dishes to Exum. Gobert, the screen. Diaw against Durant. Hood for 3. And it's Curry with the rebound.
Well, he had 1 3-pointer in the first half, but so far in the second, he's come up with goose eggs.
On a team where you have so many options, Chris, in a late-game situation, they still lean on Andre Iguodala down the stretch.
Now, he struggles with free throws at times, but when he needs to make them down the stretch, he can knock them down. And he's known to come up with huge defensive plays to close games out.
That free throw missing. And it's tied up with that one.
Nice. Tying it up. Though a little disappointed that he couldn't give him the lead.
Exum kicks to Diaw. There's a good screen. Pass to Hayward. It's good. The assist that time from Diaw. 19 points for Gordon Hayward.
I mean, he was great in his last game. Clearly, he has not lost that love and feel.
Not at all. You can tell his confidence is really soaring as a result. He wants the ball in his hands any chance he can get it.
And it's going to be out of bounds. The Jazz will take it. Pachulia, he's checked in for Golden State. Utah has gone into a funk from downtown in the fourth. Only one of their 5 3-pointers has found the bottom of the bucket. Back to Exum. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good. He'll go to the line. Warriors trail by 5. Curry passes to Thompson. Left side, Curry. With the shot. And that's an air ball. Not even close.
Just not much success when it comes to shooting.
Exum kicks to Hood. That one goes. Count it. Now it's a 7-point Jazz lead.
And they've done some nice work as we've come down the stretch here in the final quarter.
Well, part of it's been their toughness, but their execution has been spotless. It's just outstanding teamwork in this final period.
Durant kicks to Thompson. That's good, and a nice assist from Durant. Durant's got 4 assists now tonight.
Oh, that's the kind of basketball Durant wants to play, moving the ball, finding the open man. I mean, it makes everything easier offensively.
Gobert, the screen. Tia with it. Now Green defending. Here's Exum. An easy layup after coming off the pick. Exum's got 13 points in the second half.
They are just killing them on the interior.
Curry dishes to Pachulia. Green with a screen for Durant. The feed to Thompson. Goes up from the top of the key. And right on target. Good.
And for a guy who puts up huge scoring numbers almost on a nightly basis, Clay's on another planet right now.
Gobert, the screen. Three-pointer, Hayward. No good, shot missing. Durant with some nice D.
He doesn't look like himself right now. Nothing is going his way.
Hayward with some nice D. Utah leading by 5. Fader on the way, drills the three-pointer. Hayward's got 5 points now this quarter.
Assists like that have typified their effort today. Terrific ball move.
Curry passes to Thompson. Outside Curry shoots it up. Gobert pulls it in. Gobert's got 14 rebounds tonight. Going after Hayward, kicks to Exum. To Diaw. Durant against Hayward. There's the dish to Exum. On the wing, five to shoot. Pushing their lead to double digits.
Timeout.
And it's a 10-point Jazz lead.
Not really nice there. Poor technique on the screen, but savvy scoring move to save that trip down the floor.
Clearly, he's not pleased with all the looks they've given up on the inside and also to get them to tighten up that defense.
And they may have to address a number of things, including whether this is the right lineup.
Shelvin Max checked in for Utah. And let's catch up with our sideline reporter, David Aldridge.
Hey, guys. Well, Steve Kerr talked to his team during the last timeout. He said, do you want this game? Don't tell me about it. Show me and show your teammates. We've got to play better, and we've got to play harder if we're going to come back. Guys.
Thanks, David. Gobert, the screen. And he overdid it there. Too much force, it looked like, on the foul, and he's called for the flagrant.
And, Kevin, that's a pretty dangerous play right there. I mean, I don't like to see a player put an opponent in harm's way, as much as you just saw him do there. Glad they pinned a flagrant on.
Yeah, you're right, Greg. The officials were all over it. They weren't going to let him off the hook that time. And that one falls for Diaw. That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2. Put on the wing, guarded by Kurt. On its way from Hayward for 2. They had a number of cracks at it, but came away empty-handed. Warriors trailed by 11. Some nice passing by Golden State. And the Warriors miss again.
Well, his shot hasn't been going in, and they will probably have to look for someone else to step up and provide for them.
To the paint. It's stolen by Green. Diaw with the steal.
Not his best game, but they're still getting it done collectively.
It's Curry outside. Again, Curry missing.
Hard to tell if he's just lacking energy in the second half, but it does not look like he's himself out there.
And Gobert kicks to Mack. Diaw, the screen. Three-pointer, Hayward. Warriors with the rebound.
Well, perhaps he believes that he'll be able to shoot himself out of this slump, but I don't see it. He needs to quit shooting those threes.
Picked by Pachulia. Curry dishes to Thompson. Off the the mark and the drop continues.
And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Mack, the pass to Hood. Trying to find Diaw, gets it to him. Hayward kicks to Gobert. Out to Hood. Here's the three. And the rebound goes to the Warriors. Pachulia's got rebound number 10 tonight with that last one. Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
Curry dishes to Thompson. Again, the miss by Thompson. Utah leading by 11. Hayward, right side. And a foul on the shot. He'll go to the stripe for two. They get Stephen Curry. You can see the leadership qualities on display right there, guys.
You know, he's their coach on the floor. There's no doubt about that. A great communicator, a great teammate, and as you mentioned, Kevin, a tremendous leader.
Two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. Hayward hits them both. 1:39 left here in the fourth quarter. Now Thompson, picked by Pachulia. Curry. And the Warriors miss again.
And boy, has he been struggling big time here in the quarter.
Well, it hasn't been his best, just to say the least. He just needs to calm down out there and let the game come to him.
And Mack has it in the corner. Offline with his three. Warriors trail by 13.
And these are the types of games where one team clearly has the edge. Tonight, it will be a win by a large margin for Utah.
Better shooting from the charity stripe was what made the difference, I think, in this one.
Yeah, the concentration and focus was there, and I think that was what allowed them to win this war.
And it'll go down as their first official win of the new year.
And so they're able to even up the season series at a game apiece with one left to play, exacting a little revenge and really saving face. They did not want to go down 2-0. A good win, and a lot went into it. But I just like the showing for Hayward.
Man, he just had one heck of a game. He gave them an almost unstoppable option every trip down the floor. They asked a lot of him tonight, and he did not disappoint.
Hood, the pass to Mack. Gobert, the screen. Hood for three. Good, and the nice assist from Mack. And the Jazz lead by 18.
Well, if it wasn't out of reach, it is now, thanks to that last little spurt.
No, that's the nail in the coffin. Call it a game.
Here's Curry, and so it's Utah easily grabbing the win. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And now we'll send it over to David Aldridge, who is standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Gordon, a great win over a very explosive team tonight.
Yeah, they're a team you got to be physical with them. You know, you can't let them get a rhythm going with the scores and the talent that they have. So we had to really match their intensity, and I thought it was a great win.
I know that's what you guys work on extensively in the show tonight. Thanks, Gordon. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, great job. Thanks so much. Thank you for joining us. That'll do it for now. For Chris Weber, Greg Anthony, and David Aldridge, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. Now we'll head over to the award-winning Ernie Johnson, who's not too far away. EJ?
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
And Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present our Jordan player of the game, Gordon Hayward. Tonight's performance is what we've come to expect. He was a leader, not just in numerical categories, but in motivating his teammates.
The energy that Gordon Hayward plays with is always what jumps out at me. He works nonstop, whether it's in transition or in the half court. He's always grinding, and it doesn't hurt that he can light it up from the outside either. Great ball game for him tonight.
He was a threat every time they fed him the ball. He was in attack mode offensively. So much confidence. Wow, unbelievable.
And that's it for tonight. But we've got a whole new NBA season ahead of us. For Shaquille O'Neal, for Kenny the Jet Smith, for Kevin Harlan, wherever he might be, and the entire 2K Sports crew, I'm Ernie Johnson. We'll see you again very soon.